How you going there, peeps? Phil here from MTG Kiwi Philosophy here again, bringing you yet another deck tech. This time, this deck tech is a revival of the old Bant Arcades deck, and we're going to talk about our build arounds and then get into our curve and our removal. Okay, well, let's kick this off. And of course, we're going with 3 copies of High Alert, 4 copies of Arcades the Strategist, and 4 copies of Tetsuko Umezawa Fugitive. So, Arcades is a great card. It is a 4 drop and it does require all 3 colors. However, having a 3/5 with flying vigilance that can allow all of our creatures that have defended to attack and assign their combat damage for the defense is pretty awesome. And High Alert doing the same thing. So it's going to give us a better average of being able to draw into cards that allow us to actually have a higher power in defense and, of course, an attack. Hence the name, the best offense is a good defense. And of course, Tetsuko is allowing all of these creatures to attack unblockable, which is fantastic for us. And of course, High Alert has the additional ability to be able to untap creatures, which helps us in defense. And of course, Arcades has that additional bonus of whenever a defender comes into play, we get to draw a card. So that's going to be fantastic for us, because the card advantage is always really important. Alright, well, let's get into it. Okay, so in our 1 drop slots, we're going to go with 4 copies of Dive Down. In our 2 drop slot, we're going to go with 4 copies of Wall of Mist and 4 copies of Suspicious Bookcase. Dive Down's a fantastic card, and of course, working alongside High Alert, it means that we're going to be able to boost our creatures in defense that it will come attack as well, +3, and in addition, being able to give our creatures a protection at instant speed is fantastic. It's really good, and this card will combo really well with another card that can lead one creature to being close to lethal. And of course, having a 5/5 and a 4/4 for 2 drops is fantastic once we have all those play, once we have a High Alert or a Arcades in play. And Tetsuko just makes it the bonus cherry on top. It's a fantastic card, having unblockable creatures and getting in some serious damage. And of course, with the Dive Down on top of that, you're looking at 8 damage. And of course, we move into our next 2 drop card, and we're going with 3 copies of Tower Defense. Now, Tower Defense is fantastic because instant speed, being able to give our creatures +5, which will then become +5 in attack and reach, is really awesome, because it means at instant speed we can turn a 5/5 into a 10/10. And of course, if we've got the Dive Down, they try to kill it, then it makes it 13/13, and we're looking at 7 damage away from lethal, which is pretty brutal. Alright, well, let's move on to the next card.
So in our last 2 drop slot, we're going to go with 4 copies of Negate. And that's just to help us protect our creatures a little more and from board wipes and anything that we really need to worry about that will prevent us from getting to our board state. Alright, let's move on to the last creature and our removal. And of course, the last creature in this deck is 4 copies of Amaranthine Wall. At a 4 drop, 6/6, that has indestructible, it's fantastic. So we can't go wrong with this one. It's going to be really, really important that we get this into play so that we can start doing some serious damage. Alright, and of course, into our removal, we're going with 4 copies of Slaughter of the Strong. Now, we all know how this works. We get to keep all of our creatures and all their creatures go. Okay, it's time we move on.
So in our lands, we're going to go with 4 copies of Sunpetal Grove, 4 copies of Hinterland Harbor, and 4 copies of Glacial Fortress, making sure that our fixing is going to be balanced. And of course, finishing it off with 4 forests, 4 islands, and 4 plains. Yep, that's it. Keep it simple, keep it sweet. Alright, moving on to our sideboard. So in our sideboard, we're going to go with a little bit extra protection and removal, and also just some extra damage that we can possibly get through. So just trying to stick with the main theme of the deck. I mean, I can understand if someone else wants to change their sideboard and change things in and out, because that's the idea. This is just a shell for a deck, and it gives you a basis for you to choose how you want to do your design. Anyway, so we're going to go in our sideboard with 4 copies of Sheltering Light, 4 copies of Ixalan's Binding, 4 Settle the Wreckages. Now, we have these 3 cards in here for the protection, and also because Arcades is going to allow us to draw, being able to give our creature indestructible and also scry means that we can get that trigger and be able to decide whether or not we want to draw that card that we have and maybe toss it to the bottom and get something that we can probably use more efficiently. Ixalan's Binding's great for being able to remove things from a permanent basis and prevent our opponents from actually casting them again, but remember, don't get caught in the trap where you're getting bind from the bind. Of course, Settle the Wreckage is just a given. It's a great card in just about any white deck. Of course, being able to exile all attacking creatures from your opponents is fantastic. Yeah, they get the land advantage, but what do you do? Alright, well, let's move on to the last 3 cards in the deck, and they are an extra copy of High Alert, and two copies of Rally to Battle. Now, Rally to Battle is a fantastic card. Being able to untap all your creatures, give them +1/+3 is fantastic. It's another way of just boosting all of our creatures. So if we're attacking with 3/5/5 creatures and then we're able to give them +3, you know, 3/8 is pretty nasty. You know, it's seriously going to do some damage. It's lethal if they can't do anything about it. And of course, an extra high alert just to make sure we have that consistency. Now, I do understand and have the thoughts that most people have that having too many of legendary creatures or cards in your hand, they're going to do nothing. Yes, that is a possibility. We're looking for consistency, and unfortunately, some things are a little bit unlucky like that, and we do have to learn to just swallow that pill. Of course, we do have to worry about certain cards like board wipes and also Ritual of Soot, because that's just pure evil, but that's why we have the negates in there. I mean, I wouldn't be against replacing the Sheltered Lights with more counter spells as well, because I think counter spells are also a good balance for a deck. Card draw is something else we could do, but you know, that's just up to you guys really what you want to do. Of course, I did think about having the Gateway Sneak in here as well. You could make your deck a little bit slower, but with the curve so low itself, it shouldn't really affect it too much. But Gateway Sneaks also are a fantastic way of getting in some cheap damage, unblockable, and also drawing cards. All right, well, I'm Phil from MTG Kiwi Philosophy. Thanks for listening. Don't forget to smash that like button, share, and subscribe, and I'll catch you on the flip side. Ciao.